need to have a clarity of measurement. So when we are talking about intelligence, we are talking about data, we are talking about analytical skills, we are talking about, you know, thinking process and all. So we also need to have the same way for the clarity, for the measurement. But what kind of a measurement, what kind of a data here we expect is a financial and business benchmark. When we are talking about financial and business, that means, of course, whatever the there, we require some amount, okay? We say require some amount in terms of when we are talking about financial, in terms of money. When it comes talks about non-financial, it about time. The time and the money, what we are investing, we need to have a measurement of it. Today, it is quite easy, you know, to go on a social media, you do a paid campaigns and everything, and you get the number of views and everything. But if it is in turn, if it is not paying you, then it's a, you need, there is a one factor where you need to think what is going on wrong, what kind of a improvement you will be required for that. So we need to have a financial and business benchmark. So what kind of a investment I will be able to do it? Where I should do investment? Am I at the position to do investment, or what are my plans to do those investments? What are my outcomes of it? What is my profitability? What is my accountability? Also, my timeline. How much time I am investing in doing all these things? Otherwise, it will be kind of a haywire things. We are just going on doing and doing and doing. But are we learning out of it? So we need to have that data also with us. Because end of the day, even your time is a money. If you are investing, you must learn something. You must earn something. The more ever you will learn, the more ever you will earn. So we need to have this clarity of measurement too. It's about thought intelligence. What is thought intelligence? As this slide is saying, the thought is the root of everything we do. So whenever we take any action, whenever we do, I mean, whenever we respond or we react on something, there is some thought process behind it. It is actually a heart of how we feel. The feeling, your emotional things, you are thinking, everything is around your thought intelligence. If you are believing that you are going to get success out of this, you will get it. If your belief system is not strong, however the intelligence you are, however the, I mean, whichever degree you had taken before, your school marks, your college marks, whatever it is, even though you are the first ranker in the school, but if your belief system is not enough for your business, for whatever the activity you are doing, it is not going to help you out. So whenever you are doing anything, whether you are doing a small business, you are in the corporate, whatever the job you are doing, your belief system, you need to check on your belief system. Are you 100% with that fact, okay, whatever I am doing is going to be helpful for me first and for others too? Your belief system should be strong to perform well in life, whether it's a personal or it's a professional. So this intelligence you need to have. Suffering versus investing. So what is this suffering? You must have heard many of the people who are saying, you know, like, I'm not doing this thing because I don't have money. Or I'm not doing this thing because I don't have time now. So that is called as suffering. I want to do this, but I'm not able to do this. Or I'm not doing it. They're able to do it, sorry, but they are not doing it. So that is called as, that means you yourself are torturing on your own passions. That statements are contradictory. I want to do this, but I'm not doing this because I do not have time. So that is a suffering. Investing is exactly opposite of that. I want to have more money, so I am investing it. So as simple as that, if you are putting money in your lockup at home, it is not going to grow. But if you are investing somewhere, it is going to grow. Many of the people who are saying, you know, currently today I'm not having, you know, a time, so I'm not doing it. So you, Baba, there you need to understand, bhai, aapko usi liye kaam karna hai to get the time. You need to put this time to get the time. That is called as a investing. Ek halka sa farak hai do sentence mein actually, but ye thought process ko change karta hai. And the choice is with us. That intelligence is with us. Whether we will be at the side of a suffering or whether we will be at the tired side of the investing. So being an entrepreneur, being a solopreneur, we need to be always on the side of investing. If you are in the side of investing, then you will start thinking, you know, many of the people having, you know, these issues like, I cannot do digital marketing because currently I'm not having this money. Right? If you are not putting that seed, how you will get that tree? Then when you are thinking, oh no, I want to do digital marketing so that I'll get the more leads, so that I will reach to more and more people, then your mind will start, from where can I bring this money? Then things starts, you know, then your mind starts thinking, where I'm doing that extra expenses, to I'll save that and I'll invest it where I will be required. Because many of the times you have seen, people do have, you know, to spend 2,000 rupees in a hotel. But if you will ask same people to do Google marketing or something for their business, they do not have budget. I'm just giving a small example on the small numbers. This happens on the very large numbers too. So we need to think whether we will be having a life like a sufferer or whether we will be having a life like an investor. The clarity of direction. The clarity of direction, you all know, I mean, your organization's vision, mission statements, your goals, your personal goals, your professional goals. When we are talking now about business intelligence for the solopreneur and entrepreneur, about the organizational goal. Today I am taking training. Okay. So my vision is to provide, I mean, everybody will be having a different vision. I'm just taking on the hypothetical or on the majority of the data. For the trainer, providing the knowledge to many of people or students, whoever the concerned, their target audience. So that is their vision statement. But what will be their mission? I mean, currently, what is their action plan? Is their mission? What are they going to do for that? Then their goals. I'm just taking this on a very fast level. These are actually very deep topics and we need to understand properly. And we do take a sessions for this one through Zero Mind Lab. So for the goals, understanding what is the goals, and your goals should be realistic. Then whether it's your personal life and your professional life, you need to attach a timeline with it. So you need to have a clarity of direction. What are you doing? For what purpose are you doing? How are you going to execute that? What will be the impact of it? How you are going to scale it up? Today things are going fine doesn't mean that it will be a fine forever. You need to upgrade. We need to transform. So we need to have a clarity of direction. If we are having a clarity of direction, then we will provide this direction to our team members on the organizational levels. When we are talking about business entrepreneurship or as a trainer, we are not doing 9-to-5 jobs, right? So we are not getting like, you know, I have worked for 7-8 hours, I'm getting paid for those 7-8 hours. No, we are individually working. But business is all about, you know, who don't like, you know, even though I'm not working, the money should flow. I'm on a vacation, money should come. Today, if I'm going as a, I'm giving a session to some of the university, then I'm getting paid for it. Tomorrow, if I won't be able to go, there is some problem at my place, or I'm not feeling well, or I want to go for a vacation. So that, what will happen to my bank account? So business is a thing when, if you are not present, then also that money should flow. So how this will happen? Had we thought of it? Have we done any planning around it? Today I'm working, I'm getting paid for it. Or the situation nowadays, it's quite worse. I'm working, but I'm not getting paid for it. Everybody is giving for the free of things. And we just get frustrated many of the time. There is no free coach at such, but we become a part of it. As far as that is for the marketing concern or the sales, I mean, for the marketing or the advertisement purpose, it's okay to be. But for how much time? So business is the thing which should happen whether you work or you don't. It should keep on happening. When we are talking ourselves as an entrepreneur, then we need to first understand, are we doing a job in our own company? If we are not earning without our presence, then we are doing a job for our company. So to build a business without you, you need to have 4 focus areas. You need to have a committed team. Tomorrow, if somebody is calling me, you know, Sneha Kulkarni, we have arranged your session for Valor Institute of Technology. And if I'm not answerable to that call, then do you think that lead will be waiting for me? No, there are many trainers in India. If you are not, then somebody else will be there. But you need to have a team. You need to have a team who will either like your employee or a team who will help you, who are from the similar segment and who are the complementary to each other, who will become strength to each other. For example, if today for emotional intelligence, I'm not available. I can ask Mangai, can you please take that session on behalf of me? We need to have that network. We need to have that team with us. We need to have those relationship with us. And that's why I told solopreneurship doesn't exist. You need to have people connection. Clarity of thought. Or mentoring. We are going on that route, okay, where we know that matlab raste pe koi khadda hai, to hume jaake thodi na girna hai. Kisi ka experience hum log kaam mein la sakte hain. Whoever is the experienced person, we can learn from them. We can understand from them. So that's why always we require the senior persons. A mentoring. Bahut sare entrepreneurs ka ye problem hota hai. There is no one to tell them that you are going wrong here. And I always suggest, especially for this training field, be the trainer of some other institute sometime. So there is someone to watch you, to guide you. But it's in your organization, your team might won't be able to tell you that, ma'am, you are going wrong here. But for suppose tomorrow, Dr. Paulo's brand is there and I am a master trainer or I'm a trainer in his brand. So for his brand, he is definitely going to correct me. Sneha, you are going wrong here. You need to correct it here. So for all the trainer, you need to have a mentor. At the same time, you need to be a learner. I don't know how many of you knows it. Restaurant का owner जो रहता है, वो कभी उसने किचन में बर्तन भी साफ किए रहते हैं और पोछा भी मारा हुआ रहता है. So we also need to be like that. कि कहीं और जगह पे आप किसी और ब्रांड के अंदर आप ट्रेनिंग दे दो, इट विल कीप ऑन इम्प्रूविंग यू और आप उनके मेंटरशिप से काफी सारा सीखोगे. अ सिंपल एंड सस्टेनेबल सिस्टम. इन द स्टार्ट ऑफ अ बिजनेस इट माइट बी नॉट पॉसिबल टू हैव मेनी टीम मेंबर्स, मेनी डिपार्टमेंट, इट्स ओके टू बी, बट एक प्रोसेस रखो. एंड फॉर to make a system, you don't need to have, you know, your business to be on the very high level or you need to mentor this one. Like many of the time, we as a trainer, we guide each other. That is nothing but acting like a system, acting like team members. You can do improvisation here. You can, you know, have this pronunciation here. You can talk like this. Your body language can be this one. Or you can take the help from any of the member who are very good at technical level. How can I do, you know, social marketing for my trainings? How can you help me for particular task? So on the basis of your relationship, start placing your system properly. And if you are already started running a business properly, check whether you are having a simple and sustainable system. When I am talking about a sustainable system, means what? Before pandemic, we used to give a training while going physically everywhere. Our students used to come to the classes or the institutions. Now the system has changed. It comes online. Now we also need to think, today, whatever the sessions I am giving, is there any system which will overtake that one? For example, if today I'm teaching Python, okay? Python is one of the IT technology which I'm teaching, okay? Tomorrow somebody will come, or may I might be already started, or you can check it on Udemy. The learning management system came in a picture. Then will my Python training will go on? Or other system is started coming in, and what improvisation I need to have there then? What is the system there which will replace whatever the current my action plan is there? What are the digital system or any other platform which is going to replace? Like for the movie theater, now OTT came. So there are many factors comes in different segments. So we need to be always alert for this system. And that is the benefit of having relationship, network, and your team member, your mentorship. So always you need to take the knowledge from the senior. You should be always with the juniors so that new things comes in. You learn new things. So you need to know always, you know, you always have to that things in a mind that I'm not alone doing it. If you are going to do alone, you are going to finish it. You always need to have some or the other people teach you. Strategy for profitable business model. Like I said, today that LMS system came in a picture. Movies got turned to the OTT. What will be my profitable business model? Today I'm taking session for 15 students. These 15 students gone. What after that? How these students will be continuing with me or my organization consistently? What is my profitable business model? So when I'm talking, I'm taking the trainings. It's my business model. Or when I'm taking training, I will be taking sessions in the college and the universities for the institute. It's my business model. What is my profitable business model? I'm taking sessions in a university for their study. These students will get a concession when I will guide them for the startup. These startups will get concession when they will reach, you know, their organization will be 3 years and we will be providing some kind of a services to them. So here, the retention of your consumer, the retention of your customer, the retention of your, students or the whoever the your target audience is necessary. Have you thought about what will be your profitable business model? Once you start thinking on it, you will automatically start thinking of the things for the future. And you will start doing action in the present. And when you will do all these things, then only your business will start without you. Okay, so I have just touched, the overall pointers now. Through Zero Mind Lab, we provide the detailed training for all these factors, for solopreneurs, for entrepreneurs, for corporates. We give many of the skill developments. We do conduct skill development program, team bonding programs and all. Our team is having from different backgrounds, like some of them are from the human resource professionals. So right from, even though you are having a very small organization, what happened is people are, you know, quite busy in putting those requirement for the recruitment, their inductions, their entry formality, their exit formality, their motivational trainings and all. So many of the time what entrepreneurs are doing, they are doing everything themselves only. So what the time they need to put it for their skills, they are investing their time in doing all the tasks and end result is that they are ending it up nowhere. So then themselves are doing marketing, they themselves are looking for the sales, they themselves are generating leads, they are answering to it, they are looking for the technical thing, they are looking for the accounts thing, and they themselves are the trainers also. So the amount of energy where they need to put on their skills, they are putting it everywhere. And that's why you can say a 70 to 80% entrepreneurs gets failed. So we do have a team of human resource professionals. We do have a team of mentors, then medical professionals. As a part of this learning and development industry, we also believe that there are some medical conditions like if you are having a B12 low, whatever the motivational speaker says or whatever the guidance you get, whatever the mentorship you get, whatever, the real estate of your office and everything is fine, but people won't be able to perform well because they are having a B12 or the D3 deficiency. Now, every after 4-5 people are having a diabetic situations. So we also need there, people are suffering through many of the hormonal issues. So we are connected with many of the doctors who do the diagnosis of this one to get the proper productivity from the individual or on the organizational level. Then we are having some education professionals to guide for the children for their careers and all. We are connected with many of the psychologists. Also for the spiritual lectures or the spiritual guidance, we are connected with many of the Vedacharyas and Acharyas. So according to the need of individual or according to the need of the organization, we do a customized program for them, because one framework cannot fit it for all. Every individual is different. Everyone's diet is different. Everyone's upbringing is different. everyone's culture is different. So one framework cannot fit for all. So if it is on the individual level or on the organizational level, we discuss, we do diagnosis, we consult them, and then we design a program for them. So to understand on the professional front or the personal front, or for the any help in terms of a business, say business sales, marketing, or the digital guidance, we all are there. I'm having my another organization that is called TLP Globus, which is an IT company. And we serve for the, 80% of our revenue comes from digital marketing. So we do give a guidance that also. So that is all. Any questions from your side? Jyoti,
good
Dr.
content Kaudu. And good presentation.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. A lot of content to be revisited from our side. It was nice presentation.
But I would like if someone is not touching on the some of the points, like, oh, I'm not doing it in my business, or I'm not doing this thing while I'm training a training and all. I wanted, you know, that pinch should happen. And then the improvisation will come in a picture.
Exactly. Like changing our belief system and finding a way to it will really change things. I believe that. But the way is too far, but still we will be keep trying. We should be trying on that without giving
up. You will be investor always.
Yeah, investor, right. Currently, I'm only time investing. I'll do that in so, yeah.
Okay. I just want to add one point. As yes. Snake suggested, we should know about our body, how it functions. So
yes.
I recommend that all of you should buy one copy of Anatomy. It gives, the body divided into 12 functions. Now, how this body function through these 12 systems, what are the vitamins, minerals, and hormones you require, how you get it, how you absorb it, how you activate it, because a trainer or a person working in the mental health as well as a trainer, he himself should know what are the parameters that to keep you fit. Maybe we should say, if you are able to live 100 years with a good health, it means he is fit to train others also. Now I have a copy on Anatomy because my friend Dr. Kasi is a medical son, so he guides me from time to time. So I suggest all of you to have a copy of Anatomy. It is affordable, it's hardly some 350 rupees. One copy of Anatomy you should buy and keep it.
Yes, sir.
How the body functions, how to get vitamins, how to get the minerals, how to absorb them through your exercise, and how to have all the required hormones in the body to keep you. Secondly, I'm just adding to what Snake suggested. I am going in for, this learning management system. So I already started. I hope in another maybe 2 to 3 weeks, my learning management system will be in position. Now I'm starting only for transactional analysis, that is personality change. So maybe I have got around 9 to 10 skills. So I'll be making learning management system for all the 10 skills. So that is secondly.
Very good.
Second thing, all of you have to start, whatever skills you have got, instead of taking the session every time, you program the learning management system. I have got a person who can help you out. Join his program. And it is in 3 part. First is you create your content. Then you create it, then you upload it and use cloud and, automate it. Second stage is automate it. Third is upload it on the cloud. So this will probably, once, like a managing director, once you establish a factory, you hand it over to a team, and then you then move to the next area what you can develop. So as a managing director, he does not prepare, maintain, and stay there forever. So once a unit is or business is ready, hand it over to the people and move to the next business.
Yes, very true.
So like that, you know, all of us should go for learning management system. So I'm just adding to these two points. One, all the trainers, especially mental health people, should know what is how our body works, learn from the anatomy. Second is, learn and go to the learning management system, and you become a world famous leader. In fact, as I mentioned to you, my YouTube videos, 75% viewers are outside India, number one. And I expect people who are attending the class will be, throughout the world. Because as it is, I am connected on the LinkedIn around 13,000 people, Facebook around 5,000 people. So maybe my content and system will be delivered throughout the world. Before I'm making this all this content, I've gone in for training on learning English, grammar, pronunciation, voice modulation, body language. And after that, I'll be shooting my videos for preparing LMS, learning management system. So now it's a time to sum up. Now we are
going. Dr. Paul, where is that book available, Mr. Paul? Is it available in Amazon or is it?
It is available in Amazon. I can share you the link.
Oh, please, can you do it in the Zoom itself?
If everybody wants in the group, I can share it in the group itself.
Yeah, okay.
It will be helpful, yeah. Because as a trainer, as an individual, as a trainer of mental health, we cannot start without knowing anatomy. For example, yesterday I was having one session on NLP. You have got three brains, that is, the left brain, right brain, and
midbrain.
Limbic, all that. Now, depending on our personality, that brain works. So we have to program in such a way that our the correct mind works, so that we become successful. And also, he said, in NLP, they taught. Circle of influence. Now, you need to change the personality. Remember what is good in your life. Whatever good things has happened in life, if you go on cherishing it again and again, you become a positive person, so that you don't go into the negative side. And you are able to have solved this people problem. The important thing in the world to become a leader in the international level, you have to understand how to deal with people. That is people problem. So that we have to work on it. Our transactional analysis model is the best model, 12 concept, that will change the person from the existing personality to a person who is suitable for a global person. That is the first thing I learned when I joined TA. My guru, first trainer, he told me, from today you have to start following universal brotherhood. Now, I don't ask anybody from which country you belong to, which state you belong to, which religion you belong to. No, I accept a person as a human being. And I only see what is his profile, what I can learn from him, what I can share with him. That's all. These are the two things I share. And I don't judge anybody, whether he's good. Somebody asked me, is he good or is he bad? I said, I don't judge anybody. Like a chameleon, a person can change his personality, thought, feeling, behavior, every moment to moment, every day, every 1 hour. So you cannot say any time that person is good or that bad. Everybody is good. Everyone is okay. God created us prince and princess. And for us, everybody is okay. Now we go to my role. Snake. Thank you for a wonderful presentation. I learned something new, and I am sure this recording will go to the through social media. It will go to our other members and also to the people who are not even members. Also, thank you for a wonderful presentation.
Thank you.
Now, next session, next Tuesday, Mr. Nikhil Dani will be making his presentation. So I invite all of you to join the session next Tuesday 5:30. And we have this e-journal every month. So I request everybody to write articles, whatever their core competencies, so that you learn, you share whatever you know with others, so that we become a world famous world. Because nowadays, as I mentioned, Corona has brought us to the international level. So everybody, I think whoever is on the social media knows you. Keep spreading yourself through knowledge sharing sessions, e-journals, and also basically IA is promoting you. Whatever your skills are, your knowledges are there, it get showcased to the world through the social media. I think Jyoti is sharing all our on Facebook page and all that social media. I think Dr. Neeta convert all this knowledge sharing session into a YouTube video, and it is shared in her channel. So a lot of people watch our YouTube videos. So and then we expect all people to become all members to become a paid member, so that IAI is able to meet their expenses. So thank you everyone. Thanks for being part of this today's knowledge sharing session. Once again, thank you, Snake.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Snake.